Hello BA Part 1 students, today we shall discuss another literary device, and that is the metaphor. Now a metaphor is a literary device which can be used by any author, any writer, whether he is writing a novel, a short story, drama or an essay for that matter. But have you ever noticed that metaphors occur more frequently in poetries? Did you ask yourself the question, why do metaphors occur more frequently in poetry as compared to other forms of art? Well, the possible answer is that the poet is limited by a span of a very few lines within which he has to convey a powerful thought, a complex image, some strong feeling or emotion, and that is why he has to choose his words appropriately so that he can convey what he intends to convey. And for that purpose, his choice of words is very important. And when he has to use less words and convey certain things powerfully, he begins to make use of literary devices like a simile or pun or hyperbole or a metaphor. So today we shall discuss some features of a metaphor, and let us begin by understanding the definition of a metaphor. Well, a metaphor is a figure of speech that is used to make a comparison between two things that are unrelated. So when you see the comparison, you will find the things very different, apparently or superficially. But when you look deeply, you will see that there is a strong similarity. So a metaphor is a figure of speech that is used to make a comparison between two things that are unrelated but share some common characteristics. In other words, a resemblance of two contradictory words or different objects is made based on a single or some common characteristics. So, this is about the definition of the metaphor. A poet begins to use this literary device so that he can enhance and make it appealing for his readers. In a limited span of a few lines, he can choose his words wisely, use as little words as possible, but convey his emotion or his thought very powerfully. And you will find it interesting again to note that the word metaphor comes from the Latin phrase to carry over. Now, what is being carried over? The metaphor is carrying over a shared quality or a characteristics across two apparently different or distinct things. Now, what is the purpose of a metaphor? Well, the purpose of a metaphor is that it adds emphasis and color to the writing of the poet. By that I mean it makes his writing more impressive, it enhances his poem, and it makes it very appealing for the readers. Let me give you, when I said comparison of two apparently different things, when I say that, I would like to elaborate it further with examples. So, a simple phrase is sea of knowledge. Now, when I use the phrase, the metaphor sea of knowledge, can you see any similarity between sea and knowledge? No. But when you think deeply, you will realize, you will understand that just like the sea is immeasurable, you cannot measure its depth, you cannot measure the quantity of water that it contains. Similarly, the field of knowledge is immeasurable. All right? For you can use many, many lives to read and gain knowledge, and yet you will find that knowledge is unlimited. So when I say sea of knowledge, I mean just like the sea is unlimited, infinite, similarly knowledge is also unlimited and infinite. So these things looked dissimilar or unlike when we read them in the first glance. But what was the one common characteristic that we found? We found that their immeasurable infiniteness is the common characteristic that they have. Love is a rose. Love and rose. You cannot see any apparent similarity between them. But when you think deeply, you will see just as love is as beautiful, as passionate as a rose. They seem different, but they have this common characteristic. I have some more examples. He is the pillar of the state. So pillar and state. There doesn't seem to be any comparison, but when you see deep meaning, you will find that the person who is being referred to is as strong and as reliable as a pillar. So now you can see the comparison between the words pillar and the state. Now, camel is the ship of the desert. Camel and ship. The comparison is being made between a camel and a ship. But can you see any apparent likeness with them? No. Your answer would be no. But when you think deeply, you will find that just like a ship is sturdy and it passes through the storms and the roughness of the sea and brings the people and the cargo to the shore, to the destination, similarly, a camel can sturdily fight the heat of the desert and bring its passengers and the cargo to some safe place. So the camel is the ship of the desert. Now, there are two important parts of a metaphor, the tenor and the vehicle. You will have a one mark question on that, and that would be name the two parts of a metaphor. So the two parts of a metaphor are the tenor and the vehicle. Now, what is the tenor? T-E-N-O-R. The tenor is the subject to which a certain attributes or qualities are ascribed. Tenor is the subject to which certain qualities or attributes are expressed, ascribed, and the vehicle is the object whose qualities are borrowed. You see, it is so simple. Now, suppose I come back to the example, the camel is the ship of the desert. So, the camel is the subject, and which are the qualities which we are trying to transfer to the camel, which are common with the ship? That is the sturdiness of the ship. So, the camel becomes the tenor and the ship becomes the vehicle, because the quality of sturdiness of the ship is being borrowed and given to the camel. I can give you some more example. Sheila is an angel. Here, Sheila is the tenor, because Sheila, we will be borrowing some quality of the angel to describe Sheila. So, Sheila is the tenor and angel is the vehicle. Now, here Sheila is the tenor because she is shown to have the qualities of an angel, which could be that she is beautiful, she is gentle, she is delicate, and so on. So, I have already given you the example of the camel is the ship of the desert, in which the camel is the tenor, because for the camel we are borrowing the qualities of the ship. And again, I will give you another example from Albert Einstein's quote, and that is, All religions, arts and sciences are branches of the same tree. So here, which is the tenor and which is the vehicle? Now, the tenor are the branches, religions, arts and sciences. These are the tenors. And what qualities are we borrowing them? What qualities of the branch are we attributing to them? That is, they are the same part of the tree of knowledge. So this is the difference which you have to note, that the tenor is the attribute or the quality which we are giving to the subject, and the vehicle is the quality that which we are borrowing from a certain object to give it to the tenor. Now, when the poets make use of a metaphor, what difference does it make to their poetry or their piece of work? Well, when poets make use of metaphors, this is how they can decorate or enhance their poem. They can add profound messages in very few words. They can add flavors, give scope, and add new dimensions to their poems. They can increase the decorative, and rhetorical effect, and they can be used to describe people. They can be used to describe certain images. So, a metaphor is a very important figure of speech or a literary device which the poet uses to enhance his poem. For example, when I say she has a heart of stone, what do I mean? When I use the metaphor she has a heart of stone, I am trying to describe what kind of a person she is. Her heart is as hard or as unfeeling as a stone. Or when I say that I am trying to explain some concept, when I say love is a battlefield, what I am trying to say that when a person is in love, it's not an easy going for him. There are always certain difficulties in his life. So it's like a battlefield. So children, you have seen how the literary device metaphor is used successfully by a poet to convey an image, a powerful thought, emotion or feeling in a span of very few words, so that the poet can convey very powerfully his intentions or his emotions to the readers. In my next video, we shall be discussing what a simile is. Until then, see you and thank you.